How are you?
Good, how are you?
There we go. All right.
I have a doctor's appointment with Dr. Cheek.
When I was a baby, I was diagnosed with brain cancer, which caused my pituitary gland to go dormant and stunted my growth. I had a team of doctors when I lived in Pittsburgh, but since I've moved to New York, I haven't really seen a doctor, and that's why I'm seeing Dr. Cheek today.
Shauna?
Hi.
Hi, come on in. How are you today?
Good, how are you?
Good, we're gonna go right into room 4. My name is Kelly, I'm one of the medical assistants, and I'm gonna get you ready for Dr. Cheek, okay?
Okay.
I've talked to Dr. Cheek on the phone and gotten lab work done for this visit, but this is the first time I'm meeting Dr. Cheek in person.
You can just step right up. All right, so we have your weight is 51 pounds. Okay, now I'm gonna have you turn around for me if you can. And your height is 3'10" 3/4". You can go ahead and have a seat right on the bed for me, all right? Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And what brings you in today?
I'm just doing a routine checkup.
All right, so she's gonna be in just a little bit, okay?
Okay.
Checking on my health is important to me because my family does have cancer on both sides, so it does make me worried about cancer running through my system again. So I want to catch anything that happens in my body, like the first chance I can.
Hi.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, nice to meet you. Nice. I'm Dr. Cheek.
I'm Shauna.
Nice to meet you. I'm just gonna get set up.
Okay.
Get logged in. Why don't you fill me in a little bit about yourself?
Starting from the beginning?
Let's jump in there from the beginning.
Okay.
Sounds good.
I was born normal. At 6 months, they noticed that I had a tumor, and my family doctor said that it was a malignant glioma at stage 4, mm-hmm. and that I needed to get into immediate surgery.
Okay.
After the surgery, they said that the tumor was gone, but I could have a physical or a mental impairment.
Mm-hmm.
And then at 5 years old, they noticed I wasn't growing and that I was significantly shorter than everyone else. And my endocrinologist said that my pituitary gland was kind of dormant.
My condition is a form of dwarfism. It's classified as pituitary dwarfism, which just means proportional dwarfism, but due to medical issues. From my understanding, most other forms of dwarfism are genetic.
After we found out that Shauna's pituitary gland was dormant, that's when the doctors put her on growth hormones. Shauna was on and off growth hormones for years, but it was really hard for her because having shots physically hurt her so much. And then probably at 15, we saw another doctor. He got her on a different kind of growth hormones, and she got a couple more inches, but she was already in puberty at that point, which it's shut off time.
The growth hormones, they helped tremendously. I'd probably be 2 foot. But my doctor did tell us that if we had stuck with the growth hormones when I was younger and stayed on them for a constant, I'd probably be 5 foot right now.
So, do you have any questions for me today?
Specifically, I do have questions when it comes to my fertility health.
Mm-hmm.
I know that things can be affected by my height. I know that I may not be able to carry a baby. I mean, I don't plan on getting pregnant anytime soon.
But you do feel like someday you would like to be a mom?
I would like to know if I can be a mom.
Okay, if it's physically possible.
Yeah.
And I think that there are like a few factors to take into account. Specifically, yes, with smaller body size, but not a genetic form of dwarfism. It logically means that the baby that you mm-hmm. would carry would be
normal.
An average sized child.
Mm-hmm.
So in my perspective, of course, that would put you at a higher risk situation.
Yeah.
And then in addition, I know that there is the history of chemotherapy,
mm-hmm.
and depending on which chemotherapy you had, that may also impact ovarian
mm-hmm.
reserve and how many eggs and how many good eggs you have left. In a sense, it would be my recommendation that we get you set up with an OBGYN so that you have somebody that you can ask a few more questions about this too.
Now that I'm becoming an adult and I have to think about adult things, I'm starting to think about my fertility. The doctor did say it would be risky for me to have a child at my size. I knew that answer, but
I think my height would affect the ability to take care of a child tremendously. Do I think I could carry around a toddler? I can lift a 5-year-old for like 5 minutes. But I mean, the major concern when it comes to having kids though with me after they're born is the fact that they will get taller than me. That'll take a huge emotional toll, not only on me, but on my child. And that is the more concerning things for me than the physical aspect of me having a child.
What other burning questions are on your mind?
Specifically, I have migraines. I wake up with them most of the time. I go to bed with them most of the time. It's something I've kind of grown used to.
That doesn't sound great. They're happening almost every single day?
Yeah, I have one right now.
Really?
Yeah, like right back here. Like it's just a slight throbbing. And position-wise, they do, like when I lay down, is
they
when
get
I get nauseous and sensitive to light.
So I'm definitely thinking in terms of how often they're occurring for you, that I kind of want you to see the neurologist,
mm-hmm.
perhaps, because
yes.
that way they can, I don't know if they might need to do another MRI
yeah.
at some point just to follow them up. For the last few years, she's been developing pretty significant headaches. She's getting nausea, she's getting sensitivity to light and sound, so some of those are classic migraine symptoms, but you have to remember as well that she has the history of brain cancer. So I did recommend that she go see the neurologist to kind of go into more detail before we come to the conclusion that it is just classic migraine. Open up big and wide.
I think the cancer coming back is definitely something we both worry about because we know how brain cancer is not something to joke around with. It's especially the form I had.
It's almost like it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. So anything that happens to Shauna, we take it extremely serious. After Shauna's surgery to remove the cancer, there was still more left. They couldn't get it off. So she had to do chemotherapy. And you hope that it takes care of it all. You never know. But they did let me know that it would always be a concern, that it may come back. So. I really worry that it's gonna be a reality. It's almost more than a possibility. It just seems like it's going to happen. It just seems like I'm always waiting for the other ball, you know, the ball to drop. So that's kind of the stage that's my life. That's what I live in.
All right, Shauna. So I'm glad we met today. We talked a little bit about your migraine headaches, and I definitely think that it is an important aspect of your ongoing care to keep seeing the neurologist.
Mm-hmm.
And then fertility and where we go from there, I think the best option for you would be to get you established with an OBGYN
mm-hmm.
who can kind of dig into safely carrying a child and would you be able to do it to term and all of that.
Okay.
Any questions for me?
None left.
Okay, just hang out. Let me lower you down a little bit more.
Okay.
I left you too high there. Well, I think Shauna's great. I think for a 22-year-old with a rare medical condition that can't really be hidden from the world, she's done a pretty remarkable job of coming to terms with herself and accepting where she is. And I think she's gracefully moving forward in life with the limitations that she has. So she's a wonderful girl. She's a wonderful woman, maybe I should say. She's a wonderful woman. All right, come on with me. I'm gonna walk you out and then we're gonna get you set back up with a follow-up, okay?
Okay.